Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of AUC Press, I'd like to welcome you all to the launch of the History and Religious Heritage of Old Cairo, its fortress, churches, synagogue, and mosque. And I hope you get a chance to look at the book. It's a magnificent volume of essays and photographs related to the area of Cairo, first developed as the Roman fortress of Babylon, an area which retains today an astonishing collection of multi-faith monuments of late antiquity and beyond. This launch is to a considerable extent the second part of our memorial today for Mark Linz, the former director of AUC Press, as this is one of the last books that Mark was involved with and he developed. This evening we celebrate the launch of Old Cairo in a fashion which Mark would have approved of, with joy, with old friends, and with catering. Two of Mark's oldest friends, Bruce Ludwig, a trustee of AUC, and Dr. Zahi Hawass, who barely needs any introduction, will say a few words about the origin of the book and Mark's role in it. And then Dr. Tarek Swelim, one of the book authors, will talk about the book itself. As a final note, before introducing our speakers, I should say that our bookstore will remain open during the event, and I encourage you to take a look at the full range of books that we publish. As I was reminded, one of Mark's favorite sentences was, a book is not published until it is sold. So please take the opportunity to go to the bookshop and see the full range of what we do. And now I'm going to pass over to Bruce.
I don't know that I need this mic, but thank you all for coming. And I'm sorry I'm filling in for my wife who's ill and wasn't able to come to Cairo to celebrate 5 years of her work. This is the second book, the Churches of Egypt book, which he did, which is now in the second printing with AUC Press. Is also wonderful, and I think the old Cairo book was a true inspiration. And Zahi will say a couple words in just a minute, but it was really Mark's brainchild, really, and Carolyn's enthusiasm. And they went to meet with Zahi and said, we have this idea of celebrating all the religions, the basic religions, that all got along so well for hundreds of years in Cairo, and it could be a model for something today. And we want to do a book on the Roman fortress. We want to do a book on the synagogue. We want to do a book on the earliest churches in Christendom and the first mosque on the African continent, all of which are within a few blocks of one another in Old Cairo. And Zahi said, I've got 38,000 employees. I've got hundreds of employees in Old Cairo. You want unlimited access to everything there to do a book? We said, yeah. And he looked at Carolyn and he said, will it be the same quality as the church's book? And is Mark involved? I said, yes. And Zahi said, okay, you can do it. But I want to know who your text writers are. I want to know who the photographer is. I want to check this throughout because this is a major effort, but it's also a major tribute to Cairo, my Cairo, as Zahi used to say, or still says. So we put this group together, my wife put this group together. Gawdat Gabra did the first part of it, and as many of you know, he was the curator of the Coptic Museum and was one of the foremost people in that whole era, and he obviously has worked with Zahi for years and years and years, and has probably published folks in the Coptic religion. We got Gertrud van Loon from Leiden University in the Netherlands, who's the world's expert on the art and architecture of churches. Tarek Swelim, who's here, who was the Islamic scholar in our own AUC, to do the Islamic part. And Professor Seif from Cambridge University, who's the expert on the Jewish geniza that were found at the Ben Ezra temple. So Zahi approved of all those, and we wrote the checks, or I wrote the checks, and off it was. And 5 years later, using Sherif Sonbol, who's the official photographer, I still think for Al Aram, who also was the photographer on our first book, did his magic. And I'm sorry if this is cutting out, but I think you'll find the photographs, there's about 400 photographs of the book, the text is absolutely riveting, obviously the subject matter is extraordinary and very timely, And I would have to thank the AUC Press group. You know what my feeling is about Mark from a few minutes ago. Obviously, Nigel is handily taking this over. Neil was extraordinary. Miriam was extraordinary. Nabila, Tina, Lila, all of the folks at the AUC Press were just so incredible and incredibly patient while all this happened, because the revolution happened, the AUC bookstore offices were broken into, things were stolen. It set us back a year or so, but nonetheless, we're here to celebrate something today that I think is really special for Egypt. It honors Egypt, which is what the intent of our family's continued work here. As a matter of fact, Nigel and I have pretty much made a deal on two new books we're going to do with AUC Press. So I have to get to work to make sure that I've got the money to pay that, because AUC doesn't contribute anything. We put up all the money for all these books and then contribute it to AUC Press because we care about Egypt. Now I'd like to bring Dr. Hawass up here to say a couple words about the project too.
I will not say much, but I have to say that this book is really beautiful. Beautiful photographs by Sherif Sonbol. And I know two authors, Tarek Swelim and Gawdat Gabra. And I'm really very impressed with the preface by Carolyn, because she talked about Ma'at, means justice and the truth in ancient Egypt, and how the three religions, Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, came from the land of Ma'at, from the land of truth and justice. I know Bruce since more than 30 years. When I was a student at the University of Pennsylvania, he used to fly to come to see me once a month. Then really, I see him always support Egypt and make great things for my country. And this is why I love him, because what he do to Egypt is really incredible. Two things that I want to mention here. I think the incredible work that we did for the Jewish synagogues and churches and the mosques was really incredible. And I'm really glad that this book is talking about it. But I did restore one of the synagogues that I'm proud of it, which is Moses Monidimus. Beautiful synagogue now. It was ruins and surrounded by garbage. And I restored it. Many people said, why do you restore this synagogue? I said, this is a part of Egypt. If we ignore it, we ignore a big part of our history. And this is why I'm very happy that I see this book talking about all of these two important projects that we did. One is the Islamic Museum, that I'm very proud of it. And the second is the Coptic Museum, that I see really this book is mentioning it, but they did not say all the great efforts that we did for the Coptic Museum. Especially when I began to develop this museum, we had a special monuments on the wall, very fragile. And I always really want to take it out, to put it in a beautiful shop. Victor Gerges, who's a great scholar in the Coptic art, he said, if you do this, I will commit suicide. I said, but if I leave it, the museum will be ugly. He said, no, if you move it, you'll destroy it. I talked to American Research Center. They brought the best people in conservation in the world, and they took it beautifully. And after that, I met Victor Gerges. I said, I'm glad that you did not commit suicide. And we opened the museum in a beautiful way. Thanks, Bruce, for this beautiful book. And thank you all for coming to witness this. And I would like to introduce Sherif Sonbol to come to the stage. Thank you.
I'm sorry I didn't plan a word. But first of all, I want to talk about Mr. Lenz. I'm sorry I was late. When I met Mr. Lenz 20 years ago, there were no Egyptian photography books. All the books were made by, all the books about Egypt were made about foreign photographers, made by foreign photographers. The work was inspiring, the work was great, and Mr. Lenz gave me an assignment to do the first book, picture book, made by Egyptian photographer. So as a matter of fact, he made me as a photographer. And this continued. We made several books. And I owe him a lot. And I remember this day when we met somewhere in the desert in Fayoum. I was in a monastery and he came from the desert. And he said, come to my office. And I came and he introduced me to Bruce and Carolyn to start the book of the Churches of Egypt. So I owe a lot to Mr. Lenz. I owe a lot to Carolyn and Bruce because their working with them is very pleasant thing. And they are very good people and they help a lot and they help with everything they can. When we made the first book, Churches of Egypt, we covered all the churches, all the historical churches in Egypt. And then when they asked for this book again, I was a bit confused what to do to make the pictures look different. We shot, for example, the Hanging Church. And I didn't know what to do. I said, well, maybe we should use the pictures from the first book. Then we went to the church and to other churches, and we had a big challenge to look the pictures look different. So for example, in the Hanging Church, we decided to clear the church from all the benches to make it look as it was originally built and to look as if it was made by the architect, and at what was built, there were no benches. So I can imagine the effort we needed first to get the permission to clear the benches. This needs a permission from all levels. Start to the Pope, then to the Bishop, then to the priest. And the big problem was the office boys in the church. But this is the real challenge. So we finally did it and you can see the So I want to thank you all, and I want to thank Mr. Lenz, I want to thank Bruce and Carolyn. I want to thank Zahi for his permits, and maybe Tarek would like to.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. When I first started my reading my draft to my wife, she said, Tarek, you're not there to win an Oscar award. So I'm going to make it brief, and basically what I'm going to do is thank all those who promoted me and made me be part of this wonderful team. This is a book that is very beautiful, as you will find out and as you're going to read. The publication itself is written by wonderful scholars, and I'm very proud to be part of that of these scholars and to be a co-author right there, namely Dr. Gawdat Gabra, Gertrud van Loon, and Stefan Reif. And I wish they were all here tonight to celebrate and be amongst us to celebrate this lovely publication. The publication is really the product of a lot of effort of many people. Of course, it is first Mrs. Caroline Ludwig, and this was her initial idea that she was had discussed with Gawdat Gabra, and thanks to Bruce and his wonderful support for everything that is being published about Egyptian history and archaeology. Gawdat Gabra, really, I'm greatly indebted to, because he was the one who insisted that I should be part of this project. And when he first approached me. I said, you know, I have my business, I'm not into this stuff. He said, no, you are going to do it, and you're going to do it well. He's insisted that I work, and he encouraged me a great deal to, with great tolerance and flexibility as well, which I'm very grateful for. But there's also the work of Maurice Jackson, who was the art designer of the book. It's a beautiful book, so thanks to him, of course, for that. And the Sherif Sonbol, who just spoke to you a few minutes ago, the pride of Egypt, is over there. I'm sure, I mean, you've heard what Sherif said, and he said it with a lot of passion, but it is a great experience to work with Sherif. Being a photographer myself, I knew exactly how Sherif was dealing with the book. I think he produced the best that is in him of all his experience, and it was always, he was always obliging to when, and very flexible when I asked him to take, I want that particular column with that particular wall, that part of the wall, and I want it all in one. And the way that he would oblige and say, okay, we'll do it, and he's very quiet and very, very calm while doing the work, and his work is absolutely wonderful. I'm almost sure, very few people are going to read my stuff, but everybody is going to admire Sherif's wonderful photography. The Old Cairo is an unusual place. It's remarkable. It's rich. It's unique. Old Cairo has no other equal anywhere else in the world. Probably it is. It can be equaled with the city of Jerusalem. Old Cairo has the Roman fortress of Babylon, Asr al-Shama. It has the oldest synagogue in Egypt, Ben Ezra. It has the Hanging Church and the Church of Abu Sirga, two of the oldest churches in Egypt. It has the oldest mosque in Egypt, the Mosque of Amr ibn al-As, the location of that particular mosque. Nearby is the first Islamic capital of Egypt, plus the Coptic Museum. There's no other place in the world that has such a combination of religions altogether. But it's a living area. It's not only antiquities, it's living until today. And I think that the fact that we're living here with such turmoil, just 20 meters from here in Tahrir Square, and chaos all over Egypt, I think this publication should be considered as a publication of great tolerance of Egyptians and great love that the Egyptians have always lived with, and in their wonderful, glorious history. So, going back to Mark Lynn's famous statement that Neil said, and Nigel, I think, said, or Bruce, a book is never published until it is sold. And I therefore would like to add by finally concluding to go and buy it. Thank you.
Thank you, Tarek. Just one comment. He made the comment about Old Cairo being a community, and it's been a community, obviously, for thousands of years. And one of the things that intrigued Carolyn and I about this area is the continual stories that we would hear of, in the early days, the little Jewish merchant would watch over the Islam merchant next door when he would go pray. And on Saturdays, the same thing would happen. The Muslim would watch over the little Jewish storekeepers while he would go to the synagogue. And it was a real community, and Christians, Jews, and the Muslims, kids all played in the street together. It was extreme, was a community. I pray Egypt develops that community again. Thank you for coming.
I will just make one final comment. The photographs are indeed magnificent, but I have actually read the text as well. And that is excellent too. Tarek is far too modest about the text there. So we're going to end the formal proceedings, and please look at the book and go to the bookshop and enjoy yourselves, as Mark would have wished.
Okay.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Bruce. Thank you so much.
Thank you.